It was a mix of emotions. Bad because it's a new invasive species. Good because I was the one who discovered it. And then I was like, oh, cool.
It's just something simple. That's what I think is funny. Nobody realizes that how important all these little things are.
Make sure I have my vials, got my vials.
If you're an entomologist, especially if you're working in Los Angeles, you're working in a major port city, there are new insects that are constantly coming in. So I wasn't necessarily shocked hearing that there was a new species of any type of insect in LA. It's the sort of thing that happens all the time. But it's pretty unusual for it to be a new species of praying mantis. My name is Lisa Gonzalez. I'm an assistant collections manager in the entomology department at the Natural History Museum in Los Angeles County. We have a lot of different community science projects that we run at the museum.
Hey, Anna!
A lot of our urban biology projects require people submit to iNaturalist. iNaturalist is this really exciting website. People can upload data that they collect themselves. They snap a photo on their phone, and then they submit their observation. It can be of an animal, it could be of a plant. All the data that is collected on iNaturalist can then be used for a variety of research projects.
It's an Atheca. The mantis's egg case. This will hatch hundreds of baby mantises.
Well, things are looking a little rough out there. You know, the reality is that we're in a mass extinction event. How do we deal with this global biodiversity crisis? Well, we increase the amount of data that's out there to address these questions. As we think about trying to conserve species, the first thing you need to understand is where do these things occur now and where did they occur in the past? We have literally millions of specimens that document where species were found. What we now need is lots of data that tell us where species are found today so we can look at how ranges are shifting through time. The question is, how do you go about getting, you know, tons of data on where species are found today? And one of the exciting things that's really happened in sort of the last 10 to 15 years is that the opportunity to get those sorts of data has changed dramatically as a result of what people often call community science or call citizen science. There are currently tens of thousands of people all around the world on iNaturalist, contributing observations, making identifications, something on the order of 85 million species occurrence records. Huge data set that's allowing us to do statistical analyses that no individual researcher would have ever even been able to come close to creating a data set like this.
You know, when people take a photo and they submit it to iNaturalist, they don't know if it's something that is going to be a brand new species. They are like, okay, here's a cool insect. We know it's a praying mantis. Let's find out what it is. Since I've been working in entomology, projects that I've worked on have discovered where I think we're at like 70 or 80 new species of insects that are living in Los Angeles. And then on top of that, there are species that come from all over the world. Oftentimes, we're finding out about those recent introductions via people taking a photo and uploading it to iNaturalist.
So you see those four spots right there? Sometimes when you're identifying an insect, you just look for something as simple as that.
Oh. You can actually see, like, that's the monarch's body. That's fat. It's getting consumed right there. Such a cool observation. One of the non-native species we've recently detected through iNaturalist is this mantis. It's originally from southern Africa. And what's really exciting is that the earliest observations were not by professional scientists. They were actually made by kids. One kid in particular is now 13. At the time she first started making observations, I think was 9 or 10, documenting what they're eating, documenting the different kinds of plants that they're on, documenting the times of the year that we see increasing numbers of them. She, at this point, probably knows more about the South African mantis than I do.
Knock, knock. Hey, Anna. Hello, hi.
I never thought of myself as a professional entomologist. I know some things, but there's a lot of things I don't know. You have to just look at stuff a lot. Like this grass probably has lots and lots of bugs in it. But you couldn't see them unless you really got down to the grass and stared at it. For a while.
Oh, there's a grub.
Mm-hmm.
oftentimes people get started looking at things that are larger and things that are easier to spot. And then they slowly start to notice all of the little smaller stuff kind of in the cracks and in the bushes. And their whole perspective just gets blown open that there's this little miniature safari going on in even just a tiny space in their yard.
The praying mantis can turn its head very well. They do it when they're going to catch the food. At first, before we went to iNaturalist, we didn't know anything, but we came back out knowing most things in our backyard.
What we're seeing with iNaturalist is actually a return to the way science was done historically. Historically, science was a hobby. Being a naturalist was a hobby. These community science approaches, individuals are increasingly able to make important scientific observations.
Wait, I think I see one.
It's really democratizing the science. Let's see that one. So is that one opened up yet?
Uh-uh.
It's allowing just about anybody to participate.
Being an entomologist, I think it's so cool. That was the first job I ever wanted.
So Anna, you've done so much to our understanding of this species in Southern California. So we were hoping that you would want to join us as a co-author on that paper that we'll publish in the peer-reviewed literature.
Yes.
Yeah?
Yes.
That'd be great.
Well, why'd that be COVID? I want to hug you. It's not fair that it's COVID. I want to hug.
So we have another.
I can hug you, yes. We can hug each other. That's awesome, kiddo.
Not with this hand because of the
I won't hurt her.
One of the things that I love the most when I'm talking to people about insects and I see, you know, a little bit of like a light in their eyes as I'm talking to them. If you can get people to look at a little insect, which people just want to swat away or step on, if you can get them to appreciate something that may seem insignificant, that just works its way up through the rest of the natural world. We have so many distractions, phones being one thing, but here's one way where we could actually use something that normally is distracting us from the natural world and get us to go back outside, go outdoors, and engage with it.
It's a reason to be optimistic. You can amass thousands of observations of where species are found in the present, and those observations are going to outlive us. As long as there's an internet, a digital framework out there, those observations are going to continue on, and scientists of the future, conservation biologists of the future, they're all going to be able to use those observations for questions that, you know, we today probably can't even imagine.